Hey everyone, welcome to another video. Today we're going to be making a passive income video on Redbubble. How we're actually going to boost sales on any Redbubble store and how I actually did it within 48 hours turning my account around. So before I go ahead and do that and show that, let's go ahead and break down the, I guess you could say, the chapters to today's mini course. Number one, we're going to be showing you sales proof, turning around in the feed on Redbubble, a relatively brand new account. In 48 hours, going from favorites to sales, okay? Number two, we're going to be talking about the short-term sales drivers. Number three, the long-term sales drivers. There are different kind of ways we generate sales in the short term and different kinds of ways that we generate sales in the long term. We're going to be talking about that. Number four, we're going to be talking about some promotion secrets, some things that kind of Redbubble sellers don't tell you. And I'm actually going to be showing you live examples. And we'll go from there into step five. And I'm going to show exactly how many people are doing what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and get into it. So the sales proof. Let me see if I can go ahead and present this so it could be a little bit larger for you guys to actually see. This is a screenshot that I've taken literally 19 hours ago from the brand new account. And when I say brand new account, guys, the account has 147 total, or 157, something like that, 157 total designs on Redbubble. Most of the activity feed is filled with likes. So, for example, so and so favored your work. So and so favored your work. So and so favored your work. And I got kind of frustrated. I wanted to see more sales. Like, favorites don't help you make more money. So, when I say favorites don't help you make more money, guys, what I'm trying to say is just it's not money. Somebody can favorite your work all day. Doesn't add up to income in your account, but you could see here 2 days ago, a day ago, and 19 hours ago, got 4 sales in a small period. That's never happened before, and there's certain methods that I kind of took to get to that point. And when I say brand new account, like I said, for the 157 designs, for me, guys, that is a brand new account. I have multiple Redbubble accounts. After what I learned, you know, I had this idea about merch the whole time. You guys know I got terminated. But when I did get terminated, I was creating behind the scenes multiple Redbubble accounts in a certain way so that I could kind of be safe from a diversification standpoint. And the information that I said rang true. I mean, we don't own these platforms. Redbubble, Merch by Amazon, we don't own them. At the end of the day, the best thing to do is to own your own website. But the reality is you know, not doesn't always happen for everybody. That you're perfectly safe on these platforms. Some people, like me, get their account taken down. Some people don't even get accepted into Merch by Amazon. So you gotta watch out. You gotta diversify. You gotta protect your assets. So let's go ahead and continue. Sales drivers for the short term. These are methods of how to create sales on your Redbubble account. Like I said, quickly, short term. I don't do all these methods, but I'm going to share them regardless. So number one is ads. Number two, organic and paid Pinterest. Number three, organic Instagram. And lastly, organic Instagram bot. The reason why I didn't mention advertising Instagram posts is because Instagram is just overpriced. You can try paying for ads on Pinterest. I personally would recommend it. I don't do any kind of advertising on my Redbubble accounts. If I'm going to do advertising, I'm going to save that money for actual businesses that I run and that I prioritize. Redbubble is just something on the side, like I said, that's not something I pay attention to. It's not something that I personally work on. If I'm going to get work done, I'm going to hire virtual assistants to work on my Redbubble accounts for me. So now I'm going to go ahead and break down every single aspect. So ads. If you're going to use ads, you want to use some kind of ad platform that's going to be charging you a very low amount. Like I said, I don't pay for ads for when it comes down to Gumroad, because Gumroad actually has an ads platform for you. When you create a listing on Gumroad, right? Not Gumroad, excuse me, Redbubble. I don't know why I'm saying Gumroad. On Redbubble, they will do retargeting advertising for you. So, and they'll also do cold traffic advertising. But just, you know, to explain what I'm talking about here is they do advertising for you. In terms of organic and paid Pinterest, you can go to Pinterest.com and you pin every single post that you're making. But the only, and this is why I don't use Pinterest, you're going to have to sit there and do it over and over and over again. Now, there are tools that can help you, streamline the process, but it's not going to be as fast as you think. If you really want to make sales from Redbubble through Pinterest, you're going to need to take that item and pin it maybe over the course of 100 times in 3 months. So it's really, unless you can sit there and do that for every single post, Pinterest is kind of not ideal, but it's up to you once again. Paid ads, unless you can figure out something that you're going to sell for a lot of money and you make enough high profit margins, then you could do this. Now, like I said, this whole guide here, guys, this course can completely change if we weren't talking about Redbubble. You know, on Redbubble, you're taking home a percentage of the profit. You're not taking home the whole profit. You know, for me, I think about 20% of the sale. Some people are taking 10%. Some people are taking 15%, and they're taking pay cuts just because they think they're going to sell more. So, it's kind of up to you what you want to do with the advertising. I personally don't recommend it, but you could do what you want. Lastly, organic Instagram. You can create an Instagram profile and try to promote yourself. Now, if you're just going to sit there and post photos on Instagram without using an Instagram bot, you're going to have a hard time. And I actually recommend anybody to go sit there and do it. I mean, go create an Instagram account, start posting photos of the work that you're doing, and you tell me how much engagement, how much traffic you're going to get without using a bot, without paying for ads, without doing any of that. You're not going to. And the reason why is because Instagram has set up their platform specifically in 2020 to rake in billions of dollars through their ads platform. Okay. Now you can make the argument that you can sit there and create videos for your Redbubble stuff and all that, but really, are you going to sit there and go all 180% on something that you take home 20% profit? Not really. It's not ideal. So for me, what the best way to do it is using an Instagram bot. Like I said, I don't do all the methods that you're seeing here. I only do one of them. So let's go ahead and jump in to showing you how to use an Instagram bot. So I've made videos on this before. I'm going to do it again. You have to find a place where to get the Instagram bot. I personally go to followandfollowbots.com. Go over here, grab one license. One license is all you need, I'm telling you. You get a 67-pound sterling tool. And by the way, I actually know the exchange rate. I think it's like $1.26 US for every 67-pound sterling. Any country you could buy this in, I am an affiliate of these guys. And I'm a proponent of using their tool. In fact, I use it all the time. The tool is a Chrome extension tool that once you buy it, you get a private license, meaning you could use it for whatever you want to promote. I've seen, and I've actually recommended, no offense to anybody who's watching this, but I mean, this might be offensive to some people. I really don't know what to say, but strippers have used tools like this because they can't advertise on Instagram. There are people who have CBD brands who use tools like this because they can't advertise on Instagram. And what this is basically free marketing. A lot of the times there are people who just simply can't afford Instagram ads. Free marketing, use tools like this. So how does it work? You go to Instagram.com, okay? You have to have a profile that links back to your Redbubble designs, okay? Now, ideally, what you don't want to do is you don't want to have a whole bunch of different photos from different niches on your Redbubble account. I personally don't recommend that. Obviously, you could do what you want. It's your choice. It's your account. I don't recommend it. We're talking about how to maximize sales here, guys. So let's go to here to the wall mount categories, okay? If I go to this photo, okay, this is a picture of a girl with a snake on her shoulder, with the, seems like some type of garden or something. I don't know if this is an Adam and Eve kind of photo, but it's oddly interesting. Anyways, if I click on her profile, okay, all of these photos typically have the same vibe to them. They have the same theme. So in this case, a profile like this would work. Let me just, I want to go ahead and see if this person has an Instagram account. They do. Let's go ahead and click on it. Let's see if they're doing it right. And I could say they are. So they're actually doing, this is a perfect example, okay? I would do it just like this, and you could see she has 13,000 followers. Now, if she used a bot, she'd probably have maybe 40,000 followers by now. But I would post photos like this that only relate to my Redbubble. I would leave in the link in the description, but first of all, I don't know why she doesn't have a link in the description, but I would leave a link in the description to the Redbubble store, okay? Her Redbubble store, let's go back, wherever it is, right here. I would have a link in the description to her Redbubble store, which is, what is this? I don't even know. How do I get to her actual Redbubble store, guys? What's going on here? I'm clicking on her home, and I'm seeing this, her actual website, which I'm not really interested in seeing. Here it is, the Redbubble shop, okay? I would have a link in the description taking people to right here. Then what I would do is, I wouldn't know what to call this. I'm not an artist, so I wouldn't know what to call this kind of art. It's oddly peculiar, but I would search for hashtags related to whatever this is. So if we actually go to her Instagram account, maybe it can let us in on some information. Or maybe let's even check the tags. So the tags, let's see, symbolism, mysticism. Let's go to Swan, maybe. Let's just type in paintings. How about that? Now, once again, if your niche is this odd, not odd, but if it's this... look, a painting like this is very niche. I'm not sure how many people would have this in their house or something like that, or a sticker on the water bottle, but if I go to hashtag painting, let's go to hashtag painting here. If I go to hashtag painting, ideally, right, I would target people that would, you know, from a marketing standpoint, would like my images, right? And then what I would do is I would go over here to the most recent posts. I would click on one of the most recent posts. And I would take out my bot, and I would be like, okay, is this post right here good? Let's see how many followers this person has. This person has 134 followers. I would open up their account, I would open up my bot, and I would start letting the bot work. Now, to set up the numbers, I actually, like I said, I have a full course on this. Do I recommend you guys get the course? I mean, it's up to you. If you want to take this seriously, I have a course. Here it is. followonfollowbots.com. It's a $10 course, 143 students enrolled, 5-star rating. And no, guys, I don't make these numbers up. They're not fake reviews. There's not a fake website. I've promoted this course for over 2 years, or maybe even a year by now. This is the course. And basically, like I said, it tells you how to run your Instagram bot app, like the numbers that you should use. Okay. Now, I'm going to set, for the sake of this video, and I don't recommend these numbers, just so you guys can see here how this works. So, let's say I want it to wait from a minimum of 1 to 5 seconds between each follow, because I want to follow people, okay? And let's just set these numbers. Let's go ahead and hit start. Now, you could see here what the bot is doing is it's scrolling through, and it's getting the total of 50 people. Once it reaches 50, it's going to scroll back up, and it's going to start following between 1 to 5 seconds between each follow. Now, once again, I want to be very, very, very clear. I do not recommend the numbers that I'm using here. But if you want to know what numbers I do recommend, go over here and pick up the course, okay? It's that simple. I don't charge a lot for it. It's $10. If you want to get it, if you don't want it, don't go get it. All right, let's go ahead and hit stop here. It already followed 5 people. I don't want to follow these people. That's why I'm stopping the bot. But these 5 people that you've interacted with, in my case, you can interact with 150 people a day, okay? The 5 people that you're interacting with are the people that are going to see your profile. When you interact with them, they see your profile, and they come back to your profile. Let's say this is your profile. This girl's profile is, let's click on her store once again, or her profile, whatever we see here. Her Instagram, let's click on her Instagram, view artist profile. When they reach her Instagram page, they're going to see all this, okay? In every photo, I would have, like, in the link in the bio, the call to action, I would say, if you want to order this painting, or if you want to order this on a hoodie, or if you want to order this on whatever, click my link in bio, okay? Now, guys, it's easier if you're in a different niche. I really don't know what to call this niche. Maybe somebody who's an artist can educate me, please, in the comments. I don't know what to call this niche. Maybe you want to call it fancy art. I don't know what to call it, once again. But I would write in the description of the post, if you want to order this design or whatever, click the link in the bio. Then in the bio, you're going to have the link to your Redbubble store, okay? So your Redbubble store, that, let's say it looks like this, All right, you take them to this link and they're gonna now see all this stuff that they can click through. Okay, now the good thing that she did here, this person, is that they, first of all, their banner is, the art on the banner is related to the art over here. Okay, and the art, you could say they're somewhat all related. I mean, it's very interesting drawings, paintings. You could see how much of not an artist that I am when I talk about this stuff. But you guys kind of get my point here. And what's going to happen is now you're going to increase the amount of traffic you're getting to your store. Now you're bringing outside traffic. And guess what happens here, guys? Redbubble does retargeting ads for you. If you look at your stats, okay, Redbubble has these direct, there's different kinds of sources of traffic, and maybe I should put up a screenshot in the future, or maybe I'll even break this down in the future. I'll make a video in the future of why Instagram bots super grow your Redbubble account. But if you look at your analytics in Redbubble, there are different categorizations of traffic. You have direct traffic, you have organic traffic like from Google, you have Redbubble traffic. There are different categorizations. One of those categorizations, Redbubble actually pays for, and it's advertising. And what they do is they run retargeting ads. And basically what a retargeting ad is let's say a visitor sees this iPad case, okay? The fact that they were on here and they were interested in seeing it means to Redbubble that they were interested in the case. So they could go to, like, let's say a different website. Let's say they're on a blog of some sort, right? They're going to see an ad of that same case later down the road. And the average consumer needs to see the product 7 times before buying, okay? So they're going to keep seeing this. But guess what? You drove the traffic from where? You drove it from Instagram. So you brought in a whole new visitor to your Redbubble store, okay? That's kind of the magic behind it. And over time, you're increasing your amount of reach. When you increase your reach, you increase your potential for sales, okay? So that's kind of how I do it in the short term. That's kind of how I boost sales in the short term. Now let's talk about long term. So, two things. Number one, you have to have a blogging strategy. Number two, you configure a branded approach to your Redbubble account. Now, we actually went over this a little bit, but I'll explain this again. The branded approach. If I go to this person's shop, I know exactly the style of things that they sell. The ideal is for long-term average order value boost in sales, you want to have stuff that are somewhat similar. So, for example, let's say I'm shopping for designs like this, right? And I see this one, and I see this one, okay? I can't decide which one I want, so guess what? I buy both. Well, what does that do? That increases the average order value of the person who actually owns the Redbubble store. Can we all agree on that? Of course we can, right? Now, you could sit here and play devil's advocate and say, what if they don't buy both? Yes, I agree. Not everybody's going to buy both, but it increases your percentage. Now, if you ask me how much percentage that is by creating these branded kind of Redbubble shops, I'm going to say about 25% of the time. About a quarter of the time, guys, out of every 4 orders, somebody orders more than one item. You could see here in the screenshot that I added, and not just based on this, on my other stores as well. We have one store with over 1,500 designs already added. Over here, if I zoom in, can I go ahead and zoom in on this? If we look here, I actually kind of crossed it out a little bit. Somebody bought 5 glossy stickers of this specific product that I sold, and somebody bought 2 coasters here. Now, that's kind of rare. This is 50% of the time, because if we look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, out of 5 orders, 2 of them had more than 1 unit being sold. That increases the average order value. Now, something that I will say is, when we talk about average order value, either it could be more than one of a specific product, or it could be more than one product. I've had instances in time, like I said, about 25% where the consumer goes and buys 2 items from my store. Why? Because that store has a very specific theme to it, a very specific niche. And that same niche and that theme has to be encapsulated through your Redbubble account. Your Instagram account, so that when you use the bot and you drive the traffic, it's all the same thing. People can expect the same thing. For example, if I'm selling, let's say I draw a bunch of pictures of footballs and I sell them on merch, on Redbubble. Well, I'm not going to go ahead and sell a picture of an orange, right? I got to stick to that niche of sports, of footballs, of basketball, whatever. Hopefully that makes sense to everybody, okay? So the long-term approach, like I said, is number one, creating that branded approach, okay? Keep it similar, keep it, you know, niche friendly, all in one niche. The next thing is creating a blogging strategy. Now, how does this actually work logically? Let me go ahead and play it out for you guys. There are a few blogs that I have that generate me sales on clothing stores that I own, not just Redbubble, but other stuff, okay? You guys know I'm not going to be I'm not going to sit here and be a victim of Merch by Amazon's behavior by blocking me or terminating me rather. I'm going to own my own clothing stores, which I've owned for a while now, way before I even got accepted into Merch. Well, how do I do it? Like I said, I pick a certain niche. There's an example of this. I actually featured this a long time ago on the YouTube channel, but I have a blog all about like Christian stuff, like Christian Bible verses and things like that. Well, guess what? In the blog, I'm promoting certain products. And I've done this way before I even started YouTube, right? And what happens is people who read those certain blogs find those certain t-shirts on the blog, get interested in order, right? And a good example of this is, let's say, any one of these blogs, right? If I click on, for example, does clove increase testosterone, okay? I should have, and this is an example of something that I didn't do yet. Oh, here it is. This is a promo to a certain testosterone booster. And I could think logically, okay, the person here, and this is my blog, this is an example. The person is searching, does clove increase testosterone on Google? They find my article, and they read through. They realize that clove doesn't necessarily increase testosterone the right way they want. Okay, well, what do I do to increase testosterone? This is their logical thinking. I need a testosterone booster. All right, where can I order the best testosterone booster? Here it is. Boom, click buy, and it takes them to the product page of the testosterone booster. Now, I didn't actually link it properly. I'll go back and do that, but you guys kind of get my point here. Now, how do you create the blogs? I've spoken about this many, many times, and I'm probably going to speak about it many more times, but Funnelizer Pro, okay? I recommend Funnelizer Pro to every single person watching this. It is the cheapest and most effective for how, you know, the cost represents, you're getting essentially a huge bang for your buck with this tool. $8 to $9 a month for a blog. You get two pages. That's excluding the blog. That doesn't include the blog. The blog, you can have as many blog posts as you want. A blog post is not considered a page. But you get two pages. You get the whole entire blog post, the blog section. Free SEO management, kind of like, if you guys are familiar with Yoast, it's kind of like that kind of plugin in there. You get a free email marketing software in there. You get a whole bunch of different stuff, a free CRM. This tool has everything that you possibly need for the cost of $8 to $9 to start a blog. That's exactly how I do it. So I set up a blog, and the blog has to be related to what I'm selling. So for example, if I have a bunch of, and I'll give you guys an example, motivational quotes. This is exactly how I would do it. On Instagram, I would post all those motivational quotes. I would say, if you want to buy merch for these motivational quotes, click the link in bio. People, I'll run the bot. I'll run the Instagram bot. You guys literally just saw me do it, okay? Those followers grabs me attention. They click on the link. They find my products. If they don't buy right away, no big deal. Redbubble is going to retarget them through ads. They'll eventually buy later down the line. It could be in a week. It could be in 3 days. It could be in a month. Okay? If they do buy, well then great. That's extra money in my pocket. The next thing I'll do is I'll set up the blog around these motivational quotes. Whatever it is, I'll set up the blogs, I'll get creative, I'll write down the motivational quotes, and then what I'll do in every single blog post is I'll link certain photos, I'll create certain photos of the shirts or the, you know, whatever kind of merch I want to sell with little buttons that say buy now on the bottom of them. When they click the buttons, where is it going to take them? To the low, you know, to the correlated product, to the Redbubble store. And so that's how I'm going to be boosting my sales long term. I've already done this. I haven't done this specifically with Redbubble. I've done this with actual clothing stores. But I figured, you know, just for Merch by Amazon taking me down, terminating my account, I might as well show some Redbubble some love. And something that I do love about Redbubble, guys, is the fact that I get to create multiple Redbubble accounts. And you don't have to even apply to get into Redbubble. Now, you know, in general, guys, this is kind of how it's done. Now, let's go ahead and talk about how many people are actually doing this. And the answer is not many. If you guys look at anything in life, in business, in sports, in anything, the top of the industry, the most successful in the industry is probably about 1 to 2%. maybe even 5% if you're lucky, right? How many LeBron Jameses are there walking around? How many Michael Jordans are there walking around? How many Elon Musks? How many Donald Trumps of business? You might like, you might hate the guy, but he's successful. The point here is what I'm trying to say is, you're going above and beyond to succeed in a certain industry, you're gonna succeed, right? You're doing more work than everybody else. My dad always used to tell me this is, you want success that nobody else has, you gotta be willing to do work that nobody else does. And in the same notion, everything I share to you, this is stuff that very few people do on Redbubble. I'm sure there are people doing it, don't get me wrong, but they're not going all out. And you could see for here, for example, this girl who's doing these peculiar paintings on Redbubble. Okay, Redbubble, right? She's got a ton of Redbubble. I'm sure she's got a ton of Redbubble sales. I mean, let's be honest here. Let's look at her account. She's got, let's go ahead and click on them, 110 designs. She's got 2,635 followers. She's probably got a lot of designs, right? She's been featured on Redbubble. She's probably successful on Redbubble, but she's not even going above and beyond. Can you imagine if she added the link to her bio and have a simple call to action in every photo saying, hey, go buy this, go buy that, right? All I'm trying to say is, her Redbubble store would probably be in the top 5% of all stores in Redbubble. So if you guys want the success, you got to go do it. And that's step number 6. You got to go do it. You can listen to videos all day. You can, you know, pontificate. You can dream. You can fantasize about having success. But you won't get there, all right, unless you actually do it. So call to action today is, guys, go do it. Whatever you got to do. If you need to get an Instagram bot going, go do it. If you need a course to teach you what are the numbers that you should put in the Instagram bot, go do it. If you haven't set up a Redbubble store yet, go do it. You know, if you whatever you need to do to be successful, go do it. There's no room for excuses. All right. I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out. Bye.